It is bittersweet to be able to stand here. Bittersweet because the cause of this event, the cause of this rally, the cause of this press conference, the reason these young people behind me are standing here is because they are or have experienced homelessness during their educational career. It is sweet because we actually are in the right place to do something about it. One of the reasons why we came here to Harrisburg was to be able to solve the problems that are facing our communities. And the problems that are facing our communities aren't always big, bold, impacting 40% of the population problems. The problems that really need solving in our communities are when we've identified cracks in our society that folks are falling through on a day in and day out basis. When we've identified social services that we can afford, where we know the answers of what to do, and we just need the political will to step into the gap and plug those cracks. Our young people experiencing homelessness gets to be one of those items that we can solve in this building. In fact, we can work real hard to solve much of this in this budget. Yes, these young folks who are experiencing homelessness, one, exist in every school district. This is not an urban problem. This is not a suburban problem. This impacts our poorest communities as well as our wealthiest communities. This impacts rural Pennsylvania. This impacts the city of Philadelphia, Pittsburgh, Erie, Scranton, Pittston, Danville, Hazleton. What we're trying to do, though, what we get to do in this budget and every budget is put our priorities on our sleeves. What we get to do in this budget and every budget is look at the young folks behind us and say, I know now what you've been through, and you don't have to go through it anymore. It's not fair what you've been through, but the good news is, at least now that you're here, your story gets to be the story that prevents the next generation of having to suffer through homelessness while having to show up at school the next day for meals. That's the meal that you get that day. Suffering through homelessness and showing up the next day tired, showing up the next day perhaps without having had the opportunity to wash your clothes, showing up the next day early, staying late, because that's the only time that you get to be there, and who knows when mom or dad or brother or sister will come to be able to pick you up. The stories that I know from my own school district, just one building, are enough to move legislation and break hearts. What we get to do with the students behind me is make sure that those hearts are broken in each and every one of those 203 House seats that are represented, each and every one of those 50 Senate districts that are represented in this building, and we get to actually move legislation. I'm thrilled to be able to work with Izzy. I'm thrilled to be able to work with this young group of students. I personally am also the sponsor of House Bill 1330, which would prohibit our state institutions, our foster care systems, our state hospitals, our juvenile detention facilities from graduating anyone out of a residential facility into a state of homelessness. Because if we want to end homelessness for adults, we have to end homelessness for young people. This is important work, this is a great group of students, and through you and because of you, we get to do amazing things in this budget, this year, in these next couple months. It is an absolute pleasure to be able to be a part of that. Thank you for inviting me.